Dang, man, it's been 5 days already? Let's go on Twitter and see what I've been doing. I really want to see you succeed. So, like, go out there and succeed at some shit, dude. Drop a like if you're gonna live by these words for the rest of your life. Oh, and by the way, at the end of this very slow and boring tutorial video, I have a preview of my song about how 2K sold the bag this year, so make sure to watch that, you beta. What's up, Simply Squad? It's your boy, Clown Who Promises Daily Uploads Then Disappears for 5 days, and today we're doing a dribble tutorial. 5 days late. Hey, in my defense, I never said what Monday I would post this video on, so technically I could be 3 days early. Okay, we all know I didn't mean that. I'm the worst, and I understand if you unsubscribe, but before you leave, let me at least get you right with the dribble moves. If y'all could just do me one favor before I teach y'all all my moves, including my signature move, aka the misdirection glitchy behind the back, give me your top 10 guard lists in the comments. You can either list out all the top 10 guards, or you could just tell me where I would rank on your top 10 guard list, if I would at all, which I hope I do after all the work I put into grinding's top 10 week, but we'll see. Now, enough beta begging, let's just get into this. Now, before you even touch your right stick, you first need the right animation. So here are all my signature styles. Feel free to pause the video and copy all these down. Assuming you guys are ready, we're just gonna jump into what you probably clicked on the video for, how to do the glitchy behind the back off the misdirection. Now, people confuse this move a lot with the normal hesitation behind the back. To do the hesitation behind the back, all you have to do is press up on RS and then down on RS. It's the easiest move in the game, and it's also the most predictable move in the game, which is why the only time you'll ever see me use this move is when I'm bringing up the ball to set up my signature move. By the way, I've seen a lot of confusion in the comments about me calling it my signature move. I'm not saying that I made this move, but I just call it that because I don't want to say through the legs behind the back misdirection every time I commentate on that move. But anyways, I've seen a lot of people try to explain how to do this, and most of them are pretty confusing. So the way I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna tell y'all how I learned how to do it, and then I'm gonna explain it two different ways, and hopefully by the end you'll know how to do this move. So the way I learned it was I went to my mid court, I stood still while dribbling the ball in my right hand, and I just did a normal crossover, right? Just right to left crossover. So just flick your RS to the left. Then you're going to hold RT, sprint to the left, and then stop. Now your player's dribbling the ball in his left hand. This is the tricky part, so I want you to listen before you do it, all right? All at the same time, you're gonna hold RT, you're gonna flick your right stick diagonally down right, and then you're gonna move your LS to the right. Now relax, I know it's a little bit confusing. Your player probably didn't do the move right the first time. It's okay, it takes a little bit of timing. That's just how I learned it, but low-key there's another way that I know a lot of people learned it by doing this. So basically just stand still while dribbling with your left hand. Now when you stand still, there's no timing involved whatsoever. All you have to do is hold RT, flick RS diagonally down to the right, and move LS. Again, when you're standing still, you can take all the time you need. There's no timing element to it. Just get those controls down. Now that's great for learning the behind the back. Once you have the behind the back down, it makes it easier, but still the timing is the hardest part. So altogether, the move should look like this, and I'm gonna break it down in the mid court. Then I'm gonna show you clips of me doing it in the park. I'm gonna pause it and break it down. So if you're still confused, trust me, there's a lot more video to go. All right, so again, to do the crossover, I'm flicking RS to the left, then I'm sprinting out and I'm stopping. Then once you stop, you do the standing behind the back by holding RT, flicking RS diagonally down to the right, and moving LS to the right. Now, if you're doing a momentum crossover after trying to do this move, what's happening is that you're flicking RS horizontally instead of diagonally down to the right. That happened to me a lot in the beginning. Now, I'm gonna trust that you got that down. If you don't, trust me, whenever I do the park breakdowns, you'll fully understand how to do it, but I need to teach y'all one more move before we show the park clips. All right, so one thing I figured out about doing a crossover to lead into this move is that if someone is pressing you, it's a turnover 100% of the time. So instead of doing a crossover, we're gonna replace that move with a between the legs. It's super easy to do. All you have to do a standing between the legs, if you're dribbling the ball in your right hand, is flick the right stick diagonally down to the left. You're not holding RT, you're not moving your left stick, all you're doing is flicking your right stick diagonally down to the left. And that's gonna replace your crossover. So basically the new combo is a standing between the legs by doing RS diagonally down to the left. You then sprint to the left, you stop for a second, hold RT, flick RS diagonally down to the right, and move LS to the right. I'm gonna show y'all how to do this to the opposite side of the court also, but first I'm gonna get into the park clip so I could show y'all how to lead into these moves in an actual game. All right, we're at the park and we gotta cook up against some real people. This ain't the my court anymore, so you gotta bring the ball up the court. Now every time I'm taking it up, I'm thinking of how I'm gonna set up my move, and it usually comes down to one of two moves. The first move is a hesitation behind the back, so what you're gonna gonna do. You're running straight up the court. You're gonna flick RS up, then you're gonna flick RS down while moving to the left, and then you're gonna let go of RT and flick RS down again to do a behind the back to stop. Look at that. The ball is in your right hand so you can start your combo. You're gonna flick RS diagonally down to the left to do the between the legs. In these clips, it might be a crossover because they're old, but basically just do a move that puts the ball in your left hand. You're gonna sprint to the left, stop, then all at the same time, you're gonna hold RT, flick your right stick diagonally down to the right, and move your LS to the right. If you do it right, this should be the result. Now, there's other ways to set up your combo. One of my favorite ways to do it is to keep it simple and just do two behind the backs. So basically, you're running up the court. While you're running up the court holding RT, you're gonna flick RS down and move to the left, then you're gonna let go of RT and flick RS down again. I'm sorry if I'm over explaining. I know a lot of y'all know how to do the behind the back. I just need to make sure. But again, the ball is in your right hand, so you're gonna do it between the legs, a crossover, a behind the back, any move you're comfortable with to get the ball in your left hand. Then you're gonna sprint to the left, you're gonna stop, you're gonna hold RT, flick RS diagonally down to the right, and move LS to the right. Oh, and I almost forgot, I've seen a lot of comments like, yo, how do you shoot so fast after you dribble? What y'all do is you push up on RS and then hold X right away. Basically, what that does is it activates your moving hesitation, and if you hold X right away, you shoot really fast. Now, I would practice in your my court that shot timing because it takes a while to get used to. Now, every other move I know or that I use in my streams or videos are just me being creative off of this behind the back, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna teach y'all how to do the behind the back to the opposite side. Once y'all know how to do this move to both sides, you're literally unstoppable. You could do a crossover, a behind the back, a through the legs, and then do the move, and then you could do another behind the back and do the move while standing still. It's way too unpredictable. All right, now I'm hoping with a little bit of practice in your my court, you guys will get this down in about an hour or two, but I'm gonna teach y'all how to do it to the opposite side of the court real quick. All right, so basically to do it to the other side, you're gonna start by dribbling with your left hand. You're gonna flick your right stick diagonally down to the right to switch to your right hand. Then you're gonna sprint to the right, stop, then hold RT, flick the right stick diagonally down to the left, and move LS to the left. By the way, my bad if I was talking really slow in this video. It's not because I think y'all are stupid, it's because I'm literally doing the move while I'm commentating this because I'm trying to remember how to do it myself. And because you're stupid. No, I'm playing. But anyways, again, if you're having trouble doing it to this side, all you gotta do is stand still while dribbling with your right hand, hold RT, flick the right stick down to the left, and move LS to the left, and just keep practicing until you get it down. Now, there's a couple great things about learning how to do this behind the back. One, it's unpredictable. Nobody can ever see when you're gonna do this, unlike the hesitation which screams, I'm gonna do the behind the back now. Two, it creates a ton of space. Whether you ISO or set a screen, it doesn't matter. You'll always have a choice of either a three or a dunk off of this move. And three, you can get creative with this. Whatever your favorite move is can be your lead into the behind the back. So let's say you like the Kobe size up. You could switch that with the between the legs. Or maybe you like the speed boost that the standing behind the back gives you. It's completely up to you. Me personally, I like the between the legs into the glitchy behind the back, but it's completely up to y'all. Now, I know I spent either most or all of my time on this video explaining that one move, but that's because there are a lot of better dribblers than me, man. I am definitely not the person to give you an in-depth dribble tutorial. I just felt like everybody that made videos on that behind the back was explaining it super poorly, but I hope I helped y'all out a little bit. If I did, please drop a like. Let's try to get 10k likes on this video and sub with notifications on. We're almost at 400k, yo. I'm gonna be linking other dribble tutorial videos in my description as well, more advanced ones, so you can use this move and then the moves they give you and just become a god at 2k20, bro. Now, a little announcement. I will be streaming every single day on Twitch starting Monday for 2 to 4 hours, y'all. I'm officially grinding for Legend, man. I really want to go for it. I feel like I would be letting my no lives down if I didn't hit Legend this year, so I'm gonna be going for it. Hopefully we'll hit it around January-ish. And yeah, man, I'd love it if you would come watch a no life grind every now and then, man. So my Twitch link is in the description. Thank y'all so much for watching. I love you all, and as always, keep grinding.
Now when it's all done, I'ma still play, but next year I'ma need a better game. But I still watch you as a game. I'ma need to sit down. I mean to make demands, but I need you to say to me that you are scamming me. Just say to me that you are scamming me.
People like jump to conclusions on what they saw in terms of the neighborhood and this trailer. That's not the neighborhood, but you guys could.
can't get you out of my mind, no. Said I think about you all of the time, yeah. Been imagining you all in my bed.